Master Mage, Season 1, Episode 13. After finishing the aquatic monster, Fang had been exhausted as if he had lost all his powers. Master Jackie and Sam had taken him home, and from then on, he had drowsily in some nightmares. First off, the Zombie King had to get back to him and find him for revenge. While Fang was still surprised, the Zombie King's 10 sharp fingers had plunged into his chest. Everything was too fast to react to Fang. He just stood there and gave a look without reaction. Not only the Zombie King, behind Fang, but there were also zombies and the drowned bodies that Fang and his master had taken down earlier. They all came for revenge. Fang took out his weapon. He was so determined to take down all of them before he ended up his life. His sword rose up to the chest, and the magical rope was spinning in his hands. He waited for them to come towards him. Suddenly, in front of Fang, Yan appeared and gave him a smile. Fang was on cloud 9. He had no idea why Yan appeared at the moment. In his dream, Yan asked him that if he wanted to get close to her. That was a sudden question that confused Fang. He could not reply to her back. Fang hugged the girl tightly. That was so real to Fang. At the moment, Fang was unable to differentiate what was real and what was a dream. Out of the blue, the beautiful Yan's face became a demon's face. That was so horrible. He realized that was the demon he had acquired at Whorehouse. The demon had come closer to him as if she wanted to bite him in the throat. Fang got off from the girl and consecutively screamed out, "Demon!" In the meantime, Yan and Sam had always been watching him out. Seeing the unconscious Fang screamed out aloud, they got worried sick, but the two of them were unable to help. Seeing Fang was drowsy in a coma for a long time, the little Sam got worried. He kept asking Yan when Fang was about to wake up. Yan replied that Fang must have been in exhaustion, and he was just sleeping. He surely was going to awake in no time. Yan was about to dip a napkin into warm water, then wiped Fang's face. Out of a sudden, Fang sat up straight and screamed out that Yan was an ugly demon and told her to stay away from him. After Fang pulled back his consciousness, he realized that the one in front of him was really Yan, who was full of annoyance in her face. He had scolded the girl he loved badly earlier, so he got confused at the moment. Fortunately, Sam had been there. He spoke up to clear the scene. Fang had finally wakened up. He had fallen in a deep sleep one night and day straight. The little boy had thought that Fang would have never awakened. At that moment, Sam had told him that Yan had always been around him and taken care of him during his unconscious time. Fang got confused. He shyly turned back to Yan and faltered to thank Yan. He apologized to Yan for what he had told her earlier and explained that he had experienced a nightmare. Seeing Fang had been awakened and looked healthier, she just gave him a smile and told him that he had killed that aquatic monster to help people in the village. What she had done was just nothing. Fang got flattered in front of the pretty girl. He was unable to hide his happiness. He just stupidly smiled and replied that was his duty. During talking, Fang's stomach rumbled. He had slept in day and night. He must have been hungry badly at the moment. Yan could see that Fang was starving. She handed Fang his shirt and told him that she would take Fang and Sam to a European restaurant where Fang had never walked into. That was really new to Sam. He had never heard about that kind of restaurant. The two boys were like cutting off from the city the whole time and curiously asked Yan how the food at a European looked like and tasted. To Fang, no matter what kind of food he would eat, he just needed to stay close to Yan. The two boys waited for Yan for a while to wrap up her things, and they headed out together. At that moment, Yan felt very well. She was stepping ahead and leading the way for Fang and Sam while the two boys were discussing what they should eat. Sam was a little surprised when hearing that Fang had never tried European food before. Eventually, Fang realized that he had not seen his master ever since he woke up. He spoke up that where was his master and received the answer from the little Sam that Master Jackie had gone to buy some wood to repair Yan's house. Fang had to say that his master was working hard. When he was in the fight with the aquatic monster, the master had spent a lot of effort as well. Then Master Jackie had to curve him later on. While Fang was sleeping, his master had to start the house repair already. Shortly after, the three of them came to the restaurant, seeing Fang and the little Sam talking. Yan rushed them to walk faster. They stopped by a fancy decorated restaurant. A guy wearing a suit welcomed them in with a big smile at the gate. He asked them how many people they were. The guy spoke in a foreign language which Fang was unable to understand. Still, he guessed that the guy was just about to greet him, so he made an exorcist greeting pose and faltered that "nice to meet the waiter." But then, Fang got confused in front of the guy. Fortunately, Yan, right next to him, had replied to the waiter by his language that they had three people and asked him if the restaurant still had a table. A few moments later, the waiter took them inside. It was the first time for Fang to come to a European restaurant. Everything was mind-blowing to him. People around were wearing weird clothes. They didn't use chopsticks to eat but knives. Fang saw they used the knife to cut out the meat on the table. Next to them, a little red bowl looked like blood. Fang wondered if they were drinking blood. The waiter took them to a free table and asked them to have a seat then. Fang felt that he didn't belong to that kind of fancy place for a few seconds. He didn't want to let Yan know that he didn't know anything to behave in a modern European restaurant. He tried to keep his cool. The waiter gave them a small blue notebook. It looked very beautiful in front of Fang. And once again, he spoke to Fang, who didn't even understand a word. Fang had to take the notebook. Fang didn't know what to do but opened the notebook. Inside, he learned that all of the pages were written in a foreign language, which he first has seen in his life. Once again, Fang was getting awkward. Look through the notebook inside his hands, it was way more difficult to handle than when his master had taught him. He was wondering if his master was able to understand what was inside the notebook. Fang used the notebook to cover his face and turned to ask Yan shyly if Yan understood what was inside the notebook. Understand what happened? Yan returned the notebook to the waiter and talked to him as if she was ordering food. Fang saw the waiter nodded his head and quickly walked away. Before leaving, the waiter said that he would bring them the drinks first. Of course, Fang didn't get what the waiter had told them. They didn't have to wait long. The waiters brought out three trays. Each tray had a hot cup of drink in front of them. To Fang and Sam, they were not used to it. Fang had no idea what was the kind of drink in front of him. Looking around, people were all drinking it. He guessed that must have been a kind of tea from the West. Getting stuck in a mess of his thoughts, once Fang gazed at Yan, she had already taken a sip and looked very satisfied with the tea. She stared at the two boys and asked why the two of them didn't drink yet. Fang took up the cup and took a gulp, but before he could swallow the tea, he had swallowed his own saliva first. He thought that was like medicine rather than tea. Fang wanted to puke out all of the tea, but Yan was eyeing him at the moment. She was likely watching how Fang reacted to the tea. Fang was unable to puke out the tea in front of the girl. He closed his eyes and tried to swallow it. It was so bitter, he had to furrow his eyebrows. Regarding the little boy, he also had the same taste as Fang. Just holding the tea in the mouth, he had to spit the tea all out. The bitterness sent a shiver down to Sam's spine. That was the first time the little boy tasted something horrible like that. Fang had to smile out loud, gave sympathy to the little boy. Right then, their meal had been brought out. To Fang, eating at a European restaurant was way more difficult than a demon fight. He had to try so hard for his meal. Finally, he had to use his bare hand to finish the meal. When Yan checked the bill, Fang turned to the little boy and asked him if he was full yet. Normally, they needed 10 dumplings to fill up their stomach for breakfast. With a small portion at the restaurant, Fang's stomach still rumbled. And just like Fang, the little wasn't full yet. Sam faced down and didn't seem too happy. Even though the meal was very delicious, the little Sam felt like he hadn't eaten yet afterward. The three of them left the restaurant, the earlier waiter escorted them to the door. They walked away towards the highway, then saw a crowd. There must have been a street performance over there. Yan curiously dragged the two boys to come and have a look. Sam loved to see those kinds of performances, they were always new to him. He ran after the girl happily, expected to see something he had not seen in his life. Fang wasn't full yet, so he didn't have any interest in those street performances. Seeing Yan and Sam was very happy, he had to follow them. Fang walked after them unwillingly and dived into the crowd. His face didn't look like he enjoyed coming to see the performance. He faced up to watch the show, and he changed his reaction. He eye-rolled and tried to open his eyes wider to see things clearly. A young artist was putting up his hands and shouted out, "Up!" in a blink of an eye. A 50 pounds heavy stone had lifted up to the air. Next, the artist put down his hands and shouted out, "Down!" Eventually, the heavy stone got down as well. Everything happened very fast, and the stone hit the ground strongly. So that, the stone had broken a little in the edge. People around had clapped their hands to compliment. They shouted out that the artist should give them more performance. Fang also could not hold his excitement. He had to shout out, "Perfect!" to the artist in the middle of the crowd. That was the very first time Fang had seen such a unique performance. The artist held his two hands in the chest. With the satisfy on his face, he spoke out that it was his honor to perform in front of the villagers. As their wishes, he was going to give them another performance called Monkey King. After finishing his word, the artist put up his hands into the air. Out of nowhere, a cloud of white smoke had floated to the air as if someone had thrown a fist of powder in the air. That cloud of smoke had gathered and turned to black. People around could hear booming sounds from the smoke of cloud. The artist had taken out a huge rope. He said that he would use the rope to perform, and surely no one had seen from other artists ever. Right then, he tied the rope around and put it under his feet. He put his finger up to the sky and mumbled something that sounded like a spell. A few seconds later, the rope moved and flew to the sky. The interesting part was the rope got into the cloud of smoke floating above the artist's head. The artist picked up the other end of the rope under his feet and pulled it down. Weirdly, the rope was like getting stuck in the cloud. There was likely someone holding the rope from the cloud. He gazed up to the cloud and continued to spell. People stayed highly focusing on the performance. They truly had never seen that kind of unique performance before. They wondered if there was really someone in the cloud and wanted to know why the rope got stuck so that the artist was taking that hard to pull the rope down. No matter how noisy the crowd was, the artist still kept his calmness. He pulled the rope some other times, and finally, the rope was able to move. In the middle of pulling down progress, the artist started to hold the rope tightly and climbed up. At the moment the artist was able to get in the cloud, the rope had fallen down. Out of nowhere, a breeze blew by, and the black cloud of smoke was pushing away the area. The sky got clearer, and people realized that the street artist had gone with the black cloud already mysteriously. Villagers buzzed around. They would like to know where and how the artist had gone in the middle of the crowd. Suddenly, people saw the artist emerged from behind. The great performance was confusing people. The man had disappeared in front of their eyes. How he could reappear from the behind? People took a few moments to pull themselves together and eventually gave the artist big applause and shout out. People were both confused and admired from what they had seen. They wanted to see more and rushed the artist to show them what he had left. Being applauded, the artist was very happy. He said that he didn't want to let people down. He would show them the next performance in no time, called Eight Hands. Everyone got excited once hearing the performance name. To Yan and Sam, they were overexcited about what the artist would do next. Regarding Fang, he could assure that the artist was using ancient magic. The only thing that got him excited was Yan's cheerful smile. Back to the street artist, he walked slowly towards the crowd center, then joined his two hands together. He closed his eyes and consecutively mumbled something. Out of the blue, he shouted out, and two more hands were coming out from his back. Everyone had to scream out excitedly. Right then, the other hands continued to appear two by two until he got eight hands. In front of the crowd, the artist ran around and moved his hands. The hands looked surreal. Both Yan and Fang had stayed focused on the performance from the start and consecutively complimented. Fang thought the little boy must have enjoyed the show, but he realized that he didn't hear the boy's voice from the beginning. Seeing Sam's reaction next to him, Fang curiously asked what happened to the little boy. Sam was facing down. Fang tried to look at Sam closer. The little boy was also staring at the artist. His eyes got so red. Fang simply thought that the little boy was getting nervous. Sam loved that kind of performance, how he could get that reaction. Yan also noticed the little boy's weird reaction. She asked why Sam got that weird. The little boy was grinning his teeth while replying to them with a hoarse voice that the artist got a smell like the dark magics using exorcist who had controlled Sam earlier. Yan got more curious. He asked after the exorcist, who was that? Fang explained that Sam had turned to be a zombie ever since he had been in his mother's belly and raised by a dark exorcist. Smelling the familiar smell from the artist right there, Sam just got nervous. Fang tried to comfort the little boy that they should head home, and they quickly went away from the crowd and the artist. After they left there, the artist used his eight hands to throw some of the weapons. He was likely to eye on them demonically. That was very shady.